applause. Because I was expecting more, but never mind. I just... See, you know, it's hard for stand here and see the audience because you've got these big lights here. It's a nice-looking group.
They are.
And I want you to know I appreciate you coming to a show that you could have waited and seen in your living room later tonight. Of course, you'd have missed the wonderful opportunity of standing in line. Oh, before we start, I have something that's kind of in the way of a public service announcement to the parents at home. College ended 3 weeks ago, so if your kids are not home yet, I think you ought to look into it. Well, let's go to the news and see if the NBC commissary put a bid in on swale. Anyway, talk about the president a little bit. Did you see, president spoke yesterday, and he defended his administration's environmental policies. And as a matter of fact, he's reduced the number of endangered species by making them extinct. That was an extinct joke, too, wasn't it? No, Reagan has a great environmental record. In fact, Hollywood is making a movie about it. Stars Gene Kelly. It's called Singing in the Acid Rain. No. You don't seem to be sure there. Interesting thing. The president made his speech before the National Geographic Society, whose magazine carried me through puberty. Remember that? They didn't have any of the stuff they have nowadays, like Playboy and Penthouse, but the National Geographic, you know, right up the attic. The National Geographic had all those pictures of native girls.
Yeah.
Remember? And that was considered art because it was a high-class magazine. They still have the pictures of the native girls, but now it comes with a data sheet like Playboy. The Mau Mau data sheet. And it'll say turn-ons, big Watusis, turn-offs, conceited Ubangis. Did you know the president made the front page of every paper in the United States for one reason? He took his shirt off. And they had a picture of him taking his, and he's in his shirt sleeves. Now that shows you the power of the incumbency. Mondale had to take his shorts off to get the paper. Mondale's in San Francisco. He arrived saying he was looking for a good man to run with, and 36 guys showed up with quiche and sangria. So, see what, what Mondale's trying to do, he's trying to find a running mate that'll appeal to everybody. Here he's considering Ed. And their slogan may be, vote for us and you may win $1 million. KNX Radio in Los Angeles had an interesting story today. I don't know whether it's hit the papers yet, but who do you think the Russians are attacking in this country? Have you heard it? Michael Jackson. Yeah, the Russian radio are condemning Michael Jackson. They say that his music, and they say that he is being used as a tool by the Reagan administration to distract attention for what's going on. No, really. Now, I'm not surprised that the Russians think that Jackson is associated with the Republicans. I mean, you take the dark aviator glasses and the sash and the epaulettes, you know, the white sequin glove. That's your average Republican today. Actually, the Russians, I think, are envious because they had Beat It first. But they didn't know it was a song. They thought it was a way of getting information. Beat It. The big thing in this country is lately the Michael Jackson look-alike contest. They have them all over the country. There was one here the other night, and the winner of the Michael Jackson look-alike contest won a date with a Brooke Shields look-alike. But had to take along Brooke Shields' mother look-alike. Weird date. You know, when Michael Jackson wants to go out in public incognito, he disguises himself, puts on a dark glove. Obviously, you knew that, right? Did you see the new rating for films? Motion Picture Industry Today came out with a new rating category. It is called PG-13. You know what that means? That if you're 13 years old, you cannot be admitted without a parent. PG-13. That was a new rating came up with the president of the Motion Picture Association, Mr. Jack Valenti, who in his spare time is charisma coach to Judge Wapner. Apparently that code was inspired by the new violent films. Have you seen some of the new films? Have you seen Gremlins?
No.
Now, that's weird, weird picture. They're kind of like Smurfs on a caffeine high. One picture that they had big hopes for, starred Robert De Niro, did not do too well. How many of you have seen Once Upon a Time in America? That's the problem, right? Yeah. It's about Jewish gangsters, known as the Kosher Nostra. And in the big scene, Robert De Niro chains matzo balls around a guy's neck, drops him into a big vat of chicken soup. It's a weird picture. Well, what else is in the news? Silly item in the paper today. Did you know there's a new roach spray on the market that doesn't kill roaches? It makes them impotent?
That's right.
But that takes away the only reason to go to a roach motel. You can see a female roach saying to a male roach, "Yeah, come on, don't worry, it's nothing to be ashamed of. Happens to lots of guys." Anyway, we've got a great show for you tonight. We have a fine actress, one of the more provocative people who does our show, Miss Shelley Winters, is with us tonight. We have a funny young man. Why am I standing like Ed Sullivan?
I don't know.
All of a sudden, I'm.
And I also.
No. Very funny young man, Ronnie Shakes, is with us tonight. And a lovely young actress. Lovely young actress who's currently starring in Ghostbusters, Miss Annie Potts. Yeah. So, Winners, Shakes, and Potts. So stay where you are. We'll be right back. Thank you. Thank you.
Casey-ish.
We are back.
Yeah.
What was that lingering?
Yes.
Good audience tonight. Is there not a full moon, is there?
No, we had that. It's just a good crowd.
We have Shelley Winters is here tonight, Ronnie Shakes, a very funny young man, and Annie Potts. You know, she's a charming young lady. Made about 7 films, and I think her current one. What is this, something we should know?
I didn't listen to him. Johnny, I was listening to you.
Oh, that's why Fred is where he is today.
That's right. Peter keeps giving you presents.
As you know, from time to time, we do this with our studio audience.
Whether they like it or not.
Yeah, that's kind of it. It has to do with soap operas, which is one of the most...
They know.
Yes. As one of the most popular forms of television is the soap opera. And we think we probably have... sitting right here in our studio audience tonight, the would-be heroes and heroines of a soap opera. Now, what we do, unbeknownst to them, we are going to journey to our mythical town of Sludge Falls as we present... That's right, Fawns. As we present live members of our studio audience in the late-night soap opera drama... The Edge of Wetness. Yes, friends... This is Roland down the river. Roland had planned to enter the Summer Olympics, but unfortunately they don't have an event called sitting in a torn bathrobe and belching in your cat's face. Every morning in his carpool, Roland insists on sitting between two people in the back seat because he gets excited putting his foot on the hump. He hopes someday to unclog the gutters of this woman. There she is, Abby Normal. And even though her husband died 5 years ago, whenever Abby flies in an airplane, she orders an extra seat for him. Last night on a trip to Chicago, when Abby's back was turned, her late husband pinched the stewardess. Abby now feels that when her husband was alive, he cheated on her. Because at the funeral, three inflatable women showed up wearing black veils. She would love to share a straitjacket with this man. There he is, L.A. Zoo. The grossest man in Sludge Falls. He's looking forward to the Summer Olympics only because the town will smell a lot sweatier then. His five-day deodorant pads committed suicide on day two. He would... And he doesn't care about this at all. He would like to snap the danskins of this lady. Yes, Heidi Schwarzenegger. Yes, there she is, Sludge Falls' most successful bodybuilder. Heidi takes so many steroids that her hot flashes are regulated by the Atomic Energy Commission. Heidi is disappointed that the Soviet Olympic team isn't coming to town now that she's learned to say that'll be $50 in Russian. Her goal is to rotate the Pirellis of this man. Yes, there he is, Mo Slow. The man with the lowest IQ in Sludge Falls. When God handed out the brains, Mo was out back shaving with his lawnmower. The day Mo was born, the doctor told his parents, water it twice a week and keep it out of direct sunlight. Last night, he attempted to plant the petunias of this woman.
Yes.
There she is, Muriel Meidahl. The crankiest lady in Sludge Falls. Muriel enjoyed going through menopause so much, she backed up and went through it again. Yes, that's right, friends. Yes, she loves to go to a Confederate cemetery and nag Robert E. Lee. She longs to polish the doorknob of this man. Yes. There he is. Yes, friends, this is Bedford Stuyvesant, Sludge Falls' only blues singer. Bedford idolizes B.B. King so much that he keeps small metal balls in his mouth. The great moment of Bedford's life came in a men's room once when Ray Charles groped his face while searching for the paper towel dispenser. And he's dying to glaze the donut of this woman. Yes, there she is, Barb Fly. Barb likes to give her bra cups boys' nicknames. This morning, Butchie Butchie started to lose his elastic. Once in a Seattle bar, she paid extra to have male salmon spawn in her margarita glass. Her dream is to be trapped in a cave-in with this man. There he is, Shaky Pizza, the oldest person in Sludge Falls. Shaky likes to take his shoes and socks off in a movie theater and get his toes stuck in a Dr. Pepper puddle. Earlier today, he grabbed the microphone at Kmart and announced his inseam measurements to female shoppers. He'd love to ride in a blimp with this woman. Yes, there she is, Nan Flomaniac. Yes, the wildest woman in Sludge Falls. At night, Nan falls asleep by counting noon shepherds jumping over a fence. Recently, the National Safety Council ordered Nan to install airbags in her bedroom. That concludes tonight's episode. Join us next week when we bring you the end of winter. Thank you.
But good sport.
Well, you've all been...
Good sports.
All been decent sports about this, as if you had a fighting chance at all. Anyway, we have fun doing that, and the people like to do it. They go home and say, good heavens, look at me. That awful name they gave me. Shelley Winters will be out in a moment. Ronnie Shakes and Annie Potts are here, so stay where you are. Dearly beloved. This Shelley Winters is here tonight. She is never at a loss for words. She has words she hasn't even used yet, and we'll probably use them up here tonight. Would you welcome Miss Shelley Winters?
It's snowing backstage.
Is it cold back there?
Freezing. Is it freezing in the audience?
No!
I don't know. Maybe I'm having cold flashes. I don't know.
That does happen. You see, they turn...
It's freezing. My dressing room is an igloo.
See, what they do, they turn the air conditioning full up in the afternoon here because it's warm out. Now, when you get the people in here, there are 500 people up there. Backstage, there are a few people, you see. Or a few people in your dressing room.
There are a lot of people. 8 people made me up. It didn't take. It is cold backstage.
How cold is it? Have you got a joke for this?
How cold is it? No. Never mind.
Is it cold in your dressing room, too?
I can't say it. I watched Elaine Stritch last night, but I can't say it.
Wow, what do you want to say?
I went to the bathroom. It didn't work. No, never mind. No, it's like England.
Oh,
it's like
I know.
It really
mean.
Is
yeah, they
cold.
Know what you're didn't you bring somebody?
You don't have any hors d'oeuvres. They're all gone. You know, I like to do this show because they give you a drink backstage if you're nervous, and then they have little sort of salami and cheese and stuff. They're all gone. I mean, I'm on the first one on the show. There are no hors d'oeuvres.
Well, your stagehands are back there. Don't you know that?
Oh, yeah. I see.
You've worked around movies enough. You know that the guys will...
Yeah, but usually they leave a few for me.
Yeah. Well,
how you been?
Nick, I'm fine. How are you?
Listen, I have to ask you a question.
Go right ahead.
I have to ask you a question because I got a call from St. Louis. Now, I saw that shower show. You showered with 3 girls.
Oh, we do a silly thing called Shower with a Star.
Were you naked? The truth. Were you naked?
I wouldn't appear naked on television.
Well, you know, with things the way they are. What did you have on?
What do you mean, the way things are? What do you mean?
Well, you know...
You mean the liberalization of... I had a little pair of briefs on.
I mean, your wife got so much money, maybe you don't have any bathing suits. Wait a minute. No, you had a... But was it nude or something? Was it pink, your bathing... Oh.
Yes.
Well, in St. Louis, it looked naked.
Well, St. Louis has that problem.
You know, you've got a very good... You've got a very good body.
Thank you very much.
You must have been doing... You didn't used to have such a good body.
What does that mean?
No, in New York. In New York, before you came out here?
Yeah.
Once you did a sketch with me and you had a tennis shorts on.
Yeah.
And I think that's what I mean.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I filled out.
Yes, you filled. You've been doing exercising.
Yeah.
Yes, I see a lot.
Yeah.
Okay, let's change the subject. I would like to do a shower scene with you sometime. When I'm on, not today, it's too cold.
Yes, I know.
In the winter when you have the heat on, I would like to.
You would strip down to a bikini and get in the shower?
I wouldn't even strip down to a bikini outside at the beach. I wear a 1990 bathing suit on the beach. Everybody thinks it's chic.
You mean the one with the skirt?
Ruffles and a pants and a little skirt.
Oh, you must be adorable.
Yes.
Yeah. No, I wouldn't do it. All right, let's talk about... Somebody told me you went back to high school. Now, is that a makeup or what?
No.
You went back to school?
Well, sort of. Yes, I'm going to Fairfax High School. I thought about an adult education at night. I did 3 pictures in a row, 4. All over the world. Maybe I'm cold because I got a cold in England.
Could be.
And I developed something called chronic bronchitis, which I think I'm over. But I hope I'm over. But today may start it up again. But anyway, what was I saying? Fairfax High School. My next book is called All Tributaries and No Stream. So would you bring me back to what I'm talking
Absolutely.
About after I go up? Anyway, what was I saying?
I don't know.
Oh, well, I...
Does Fairfax High School ring a bell?
Yes, that's right. Now the adult summer high school is starting, and I've gone 3 days, and I'm taking typing, which
well,
I mean
that's
I
good.
Can type, but nobody can read it except me.
What do you mean?
I type in code. You know, my first version. When I wrote my book, I did first on pink paper, and then orange, and then yellow, and then you get to a secretary. But most secretaries have gurus now. Or something like that, or they don't show up, or I have to go do exercise at Jane Fonda's, or...
What the hell are you talking about?
I'm saying about why I'm studying typing.
Ah.
You don't think I'm trying to be a secretary?
No, I knew you're not going to looking for work, but why do you want to type?
Because I'm writing my second book. You're in it.
I'm in the second one.
Yes, you're in the second
one. Isn't that nice?
Because I started doing...
I hope it's nice.
Yes, it is nice. When did you start doing The Tonight Show in New York?
1962.
Not 56?
Why would I lie about that? 62.
Gee, I've got to change the book.
Well, that's not difficult to check.
Well, I remember everything. I just don't remember when it happened. Everything.
Well,
a lot
of people are that way. You're not good with dates.
No, I'm not.
But you can remember moments in history and...
Everything. Word for word, exactly what happened.
Okay.
And do you remember the days of the Playboy bunnies at the factory?
Well...
They don't even know what the factory is.
It was a
private club out here. And the Playboy bunnies, after working hours, would go there when the Playboy bunnies were the thing.
I think I went there maybe once or twice.
Three or four. These were the days when
you had a lot of energy. What you're going to talk about in your book?
Well, I'm not going to talk about the election.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, anyway...
I got to do a commercial first.
Why? No. I thought you did it in your monologue.
Commercial?
You did a commercial for the Republican Party.
Oh, no. Not really.
What about equal time?
It doesn't apply in a monologue.
Oh, I see.
Only if we have a vowed candidate on here.
Oh, I see.
You're not a candidate, are you?
Well, maybe.
You're kidding.
Well, I could. Everybody else is trying.
Mondale's looking for somebody.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll take a break. We'll be right back. Very nice. That's very nice. Okay, now we'll switch back and forth. Okay. Let's get you back in school. You went to learn to type so you could do your book.
A couple of years ago, I was in England. It was somewhere that Cary Grant was, and I asked him why...
You were with Cary Grant?
Well, not in the biblical sense, but...
Well, I didn't mean that.
I wish. Anyway, we were somewhere, and I asked him...
Did you know Cary Grant that well?
Yes. Yes, I do. I've met him at parties, and when I first came out here, he lived in a place where I lived at Peyton Hall. But anyway, I was somewhere at a party in England. I asked him why he looked so young and looks so wonderful.
He looks great.
You know what he told me? That every year he learns something new. He takes up a new thing, French, horseback riding.
New interest, that's a good idea.
Yes, a new interest every year, and he's around young people, and it's in here, not getting your face lifted.
Right.
That's the trick of staying young, being interested in things. So I decided this summer, I was very tired, I'd done a lot of films, and I decided to take up photography again, and I've never really typed. I've kind of, sort of known it, and I want to know it thoroughly. And I've got a wonderful teacher at Fairfax High, except they chain the books to the desks.
Times have changed. Yes.
Yes, and the typewriters. So, you know, if you want to move the book, it's a little difficult. And I'm taking political science, and who knows? Anyway, I'm going every night from 6.
Are you good yet?
No, I've always been sort of fast, but inaccurate.
Uh-huh. Which... What would your typing speed be?
Rather describes my life.
Yeah.
I said it, you didn't.
No, I didn't say it.
Okay.
What kind of typing speed are you shooting for? 50, 60, 70 words
yes,
a minute?
Yes, 40, oh,
that's
50.
Good.
Just
that's good.
So that, one of the things that's wrong is when I type, I don't look at anything. In fact, I close my eyes and think. And they're teaching me to look at something, you know? So I have to, I don't like to do that. I like to just think in my head. But you follow a certain pattern, and you, but what's curious about the high school, and rather wonderful, I decided I wanted... It's like the Tower of Babel.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite a statement about our country. People speak Spanish, Puerto Rican, Arabic, Hebrew, Russian, a great many Russian, and a couple of other languages that I don't recognize.
Swahili?
Maybe. And anyway, and you wonder why are all these people, they have English as a second language is the big thing at Fairfax High. And you go in the hallways and you say, why are all these people in America learning English as a second language? You know why? It's because of the promise of this country.
I'm sure.
And the opportunity. I don't see anybody... Well, I've been to other countries. I didn't go to high school, but I've been to Russia, and I've been to Greece and Turkey and England. I don't see people flooding in over the borders.
No, they come here.
I hope we have room for maybe all that empty space in the Middle West.
Our whole country was based on that. Compassion for the minorities.
Yeah. And it's a fascinating thing to do. I mean, I've been into a lot of restaurants and nightclubs, so I thought I would try this. I hope I last out the 6 weeks.
You'll
make
it.
Do you feel like studying something new?
What?
You feel like studying something new? Like, I feel you should study law.
It would save me a great deal of money. Yes, you're right. Yeah, that would have been a wise move, I think.
Yes.
I could have handled all these details myself.
It's just if we studied law, we wouldn't need all the lawyers and the agents, and we could...
That's probably true.
You know, but...
When you were in high school originally...
Yes.
Were you a good student?
Yes, but I had to leave, or I did leave, 6 months before graduation.
Oh, that's
a
shame.
I went to Thomas Jefferson High School in Brooklyn.
Why'd you leave?
Well, because I got a job as a model, and I got $100 a week, and my father was only making 82.
That was a fortune.
Yes, in those days. Well, it wasn't that long ago.
Well, I didn't say anything. I just said that was a fortune.
Yes,
you said in those days. I didn't say in those days.
It's true. Yes, it was.
Did I say in those days?
No, you didn't.
You said that.
You're right. You're getting sensitive about age.
No.
Yes,
not a bit.
Yesterday, you were reading those kids' things, you know,
right. Well,
and they said you were 63, 46.
Making humorous comments. No, it doesn't bother me.
But you got pale under your makeup. I could see it on television last night. Every time one of the kids said, I think Mr. Carson is 63, and
you
said, where did they get that number, 63? Give me a break.
That's right.
Are you scared of age?
Not a bit.
You're going to be here at 94. You're going to be here doing this show.
You're kidding.
No, I know. I'm a bit of a psychic. You know that lady who was here last night, Alice?
Alice Neal.
Who's 84. How much? She was a great. You just got to watch every night. She's a great painter.
Great. One of the greats.
One of the great artists.
Yeah.
And she's 84, and she sounded younger than most of the people you'd had on during the week. She also had
four husbands and lots of lovers.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah. I've had three.
Yeah, three husbands.
Yes, I'm thinking
about you'll ever get married again?
No, not really. Well, the need to get married isn't... I never was married. I got... to get married, it was kind of a thing you did when you were under contract. You sort of proved you could get married.
Oh, I see.
But when
the
they
image, you mean?
Yes, but they wanted to come in the house after the honeymoon. It confused me. I just sort of felt that... I don't think I like being married. I like getting married.
You're kind of in love with the idea of being in love.
Yes, that's it. Maybe as I'm getting older, maybe they have a course in that at school. I don't know.
They probably do.
Yes, they do.
All schools, especially high schools, even junior high schools, should have a course in marriage or personal relationships, and most of them don't. Maybe they do now.
You're right.
But they didn't when I went to school, and they should, because that's what most kids do when they get out. And you never learn that. How to get along with somebody else on a one-to-one relationship. And they should start that when the kids are 12, 13, and certainly in high school.
That's a very good idea.
Why not?
It's true.
After the fact, I am brilliant. We'll take a break. We'll be right back with Ronnie Shake. Okay, now, you're about to meet a young man who's been with us before. Ronnie's from New York. He's very funny, slightly eccentric, and as New Yorkers tend to be. He appears frequently at Catch a Rising Star in Manhattan. Would you welcome Ronnie Shakes? Ronnie?
Thank you so much. Season's greetings, by the way. As you can see, I've experienced a lot of pain in my life. Thanks for the concern. Yeah, I got out of hospital a couple months ago. I was in the ICU, intensive care unit. Every hour, a nurse would come around and whisper in my ear, "Your family loves you, despite the tremendous financial burden that you are." But families are important. My father had all the answers. Once I asked him, I said, "You know, Dad, you're born. Eventually, you have to die. Why the hell are you born in the first place?" Tear came through his eye. He put his arm around my shoulder. He said, Ronnie, tax purposes. Growing up is tough being a kid, you know? I know my greatest concern was fitting in, being part of the crowd, one of the guys. I went to an all-black school. I persuaded them to print my negative in the yearbook. Pretty sure it was the black teeth that gave me away. Who's this old guy with the white hair and the bad teeth? Looks like Shakes. He's such a jerk. But you learn a lot in school, and that's what's important. I learned in physics that matter cannot be destroyed, only transformed. Dad, don't think of the car as totaled. I made it into a paperweight for you. You might want to get a bigger desk. But there are certain moments, certain events that solidify the father-son relationship. I recall when Dad taught me how to ride a bicycle. He said, Ronnie, come up to the roof. Isn't it dangerous up there, Dad? Nah, there's no traffic. You'll be fine. I had a very traumatic childhood experience. I was kidnapped. They sent my father a note, $1,000 in exchange for your son. He wrote back, I'll take it. Smart to cooperate, I think, yeah. My whole family's nuts. It's not just me and my immediate parents. Grandma's kind of nuts. I like Grandma, though. She's a morbid soul. She's the only person I've ever met that actually knows the words to Taps. Yeah, she's morbid. She reads the obituaries every day, then crosses the names out of the telephone book. She keeps our directory right up to date. It's good. By noon, we have all those deletions. It's so nice. Flying! I flew out here to California to get a little rest, relaxation. They make it so difficult buying a ticket nowadays, you know? They want to know everything. First class, ambassador class, smoking, non-smoking. This time, they want to know my sexual preference. I flew standby. I don't need that pressure in the airport, no. I have carry-on luggage. But I read somewhere, I think in a medical journal, that sex is 99% mental. It's frightening how good that 1% feels. Two, 3%, I think you would disintegrate. That's just my opinion and nobody's asking me. A lot of couples nowadays, they worry. They worry about this simultaneous ecstasy. Not me. I'm happy to be in the same room. Spare me the details. But every once in a while, after lovemaking, when things have gone just right, it's always the greatest thing in the world for a man to hear a woman say, this one's on the house.
Ronnie Shakes. He's a funny kid, isn't he? He's funny stuff. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Annie Potts is with us. Stay here. Here's a charming young lady. This is Annie Potts, who is currently in the film Ghostbusters, is making her first appearance on The Tonight Show, and she's been in about, I think, 6 or 7 motion pictures. Would you welcome, please, Annie Potts. Annie. You had that look as you came around the court. Would you like a footstool?
I'm pretty sure.
We have a little stool there. There you
Thanks.
Are. Did you always want to be taller?
Well, I always wanted to be several things. I thought that if I were a little taller, that I would have another body altogether, and I always thought that that would be nice. But...
yeah.
But no. this one is works.
It looks very serviceable.
Thanks. Yeah. It does.
Well, I mean, you know what I meant. How many jokes do you get about your name, Annie Potts? I mean.
Well,
last night when I said we have Winters, Shakes, and Potts on the show tonight, and I said, sounds like a law firm or something, but you get kidded? Especially children do it, I know.
Yeah, Potsy,
yeah.
That sort of thing.
Yeah.
But I didn't get nearly as many jokes with mine as my family did. My mother, who of course had another name before she married, which was a nice name. But her first name was Dorothy, but nobody called her Dorothy. They called her Dot. So then she got married, and then her name was...
Dot Potts.
And I remember as a little child, you know, when my father would introduce her, he would go, this is my wife, Dot Potts, and they'd go. They would always laugh, and I wondered why they were laughing at my mother, because I thought she was so pretty.
You started to do an accent there when you say your father was introducing. Did he talk?
I'm going to do my father, I have to do him, you know.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I'm from the South.
You're from the South. Whereabouts? Yeah.
I'm from Franklin, Kentucky.
Franklin, Kentucky. Mm-hmm. But you don't have a pronounced Southern accent at all.
Well, that...
A little bit.
Yeah, sometimes it's more in the rhythms, you know, than anything else. But there are things that I can't say, like... the Southerners do more than anything is extend things, like I can't say door. I mean, it's just one thing. We say it'll be like 5 syllables, door.
Going through the door.
Door.
Yeah.
Four.
How do you pronounce S-T-O-R-E?
Stoa.
Yeah, stoa. Yeah. See, in Mississippi, they say stoa.
Stoa.
Going to stoa.
Yeah.
It's just S-T-O, period.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ghostbusters is doing very well, isn't it?
Oh, it's doing great.
Yeah,
doing
great.
Have you seen it?
Yeah. Now, you mentioned your dad and your mother. I understand that they are in the entertainment business, or one of them was.
Well, my mother was a singer for a little while. You know, back in the old days, they would sing till they met the husband.
Now, when you say old days, old days to you may be different.
Well, the war.
Which war? World War II, you're talking about.
World War II.
Yeah.
You know, he was a major in the Air Force.
He was.
And she was, yeah. And she was singing in a nightclub, the Boots and Saddles. In Bowling Green, Kentucky. She and Carolyn Malone, I think her name was, and they used to sing things, and my father was
things.
Not
things.
And I guess he thought she's pretty cute.
Well, she must have. He married her, right?
Right.
Was she singing when your father met her?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you sing at all?
Yeah, I do.
Are you good?
Well, sometimes. I mean, I got a little laryngitis right now, so I wouldn't... I mean, the voice is funny anyway, but...
Your voice isn't funny.
Thank you.
Yeah, we're very nice.
Yeah, I do. I haven't in a while, though. I used to do a lot of musical comedy, and then I didn't anymore. And
did you travel around with your dad? Now, most kids were what they call service brats.
No, he wasn't alive for anything. He quit.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, you know, after the war.
Yeah. Now, where'd you study acting? Now, Shelley coaches acting, you know.
Yes, I know.
And she's a very good coach.
I know you from somewhere. Otherwise, I've seen you in some great movies. I can't remember which.
Well, maybe it was one we did together.
As Shelley said, she has perfect recall, not for dates, but...
We did a picture together?
Yeah.
What was it? I did this to Paul Newman, so
you
it's
did?
All right.
Oh, it's okay. We did a film called King of the Gypsies together.
Of course, and you were wonderful in it.
You were...
Oh. That takes guts, but you got away with it.
Yes, I remember the date of that one. I know when that was.
So you actually worked together. That's fun.
Yes.
She didn't remember.
Well, we didn't have any scenes together, did we?
Just the great...
Just the climactic scene, probably.
Yes, as a matter of fact...
Did you have any scenes with her at all?
The graveyard in New Jersey, remember
that? Oh, that's right. We were only there a week or 10 days.
Hardly long enough to remember anybody.
I was the one standing next to you.
Oh. But you were holding an umbrella?
Yes, that's it!
You had to luck in sooner or later.
Yes. You know, once I did this show with Paul Newman.
How could you not remember being in a picture with Paul Newman?
Let me tell you. And we're both in the board of directors of the Actors Studio. We know each other a long time. And we were like sitting talking about something. And you said, have you two ever done a film together? And I said, no. And Paul Newman looked at me sort of strangely, even stranger than you just looked at me, and said... what was I in Harper? Chop liver? But in Harper, I was supposed to have been drunk through the whole picture.
Yes.
And he said, I made love to you for 3 days.
We'll be right back. Stay where you are. Okay, we just have time to thank everybody. You're delightful. Will you come back and do this again some night?